'Twas the year 300 BC. Euclid of Alexandria, the Greek mathematician, was working with what he called points, lines, and planes. No, not that kind of plane. They did not have that in 300 BC. Now, there we go, that kind of plane, yeah. What Euclid was doing was studying geometry, which is the branch of mathematics concerned with all things related to points, lines, and planes. Euclid realized that he could make points into lines, lines into shapes, shapes into three-dimensional figures. We have angles, triangles, quadrilaterals. We could find measurements, area, volume, all because of points, lines, and planes. Wow, what an interesting dude. Thanks, Euclid. We get to make an entire course because of you now. Welcome to geometry, Euclidean geometry. There are other kinds of geometries out there, but in this course, we get to focus exclusively on what Euclid found out and where his findings led us. Let's get started. In this geometry introduction video, I want to talk to you about how the units in this course are set up, some strategies that'll help you be successful in the course and to get the most out of your learning time, and where to find your first assignment exploring the purpose of geometry. Let's start by going over the structure of this course. You'll have lessons. In each lesson, we'll have a video. After every few lessons, you'll get a wrap-up. A wrap-up, you can kind of think of like a quiz because they'll be made up of practice questions related to the previous lessons. These are important for helping you remember what you've learned. At the end of each unit, you'll receive a unit wrap-up made up of questions pertaining to the entire unit. So you can think of these like a unit test. Unit wrap-ups are important for showing that you've been practicing the skills you're learning and you're retaining the information. Many of the units will have additional projects and activities for you to complete too. These are a chance for you to show off your skills in a different way. Some of them will even have rubrics that your parents can fill out and give you a grade. Don't worry, we'll show you the rubrics too so that you know what to focus on. In fact, many of these projects and activities will come right before the unit wrap-up, giving you an extra bit of practice before you take the assessment. Listen, the most important things I want you to take away from this course are some good habits, like solid note-taking, taking notes that you can come back to later and still understand. We actually have notes templates for every unit available for you to download at the very first lesson at each unit. As a matter of fact, there's actually a notes template for this video. You know what? You should go get it. Yeah. It's in the teacher section. Don't worry, the video will come back to this very spot, so pause the video now, go get those notes. All right, now that you've got the notes template, you can practice going through it while we continue. The notes template goes through the unit by each lesson, and I'll even feature some of the same practice questions that we go over in those lessons. Your parents will also have a teacher version of the notes that are completely filled out available at the final lesson of each unit. They can download and provide it for you at any time if they feel like it would help you out to have a completed version of the notes ahead of time. Note-taking is a very important skill that I want you to work on throughout this course. You may even refer back to these notes once you're in college, so always make sure that you're doing a good job with your notes. I also want to encourage you to utilize the wrap-up checklist found in the PDFs for the wrap-up lessons to reflect on your learning and progress. Remember, all the lessons you do can be found in your profile. So if you get to the wrap-up lesson and realize you want to go over or review something, you can go back to that old lesson and rewatch part or all of the video until you feel like you're ready to take on the assessment. Also, in that same vein, These lessons and projects should never be rushed. Sometimes we do our best work when we think about something and come back to it. So don't feel the need to rush through any of these topics. If you're struggling with something, that's okay. Take a break. Come back to the video later. Do some of your own research and never settle for a partial understanding of something or give up just because you're not getting it on the first try. You will want these ideas to stay in your long-term memory, so give them the time they need. So, where can points, lines, and planes take us? Well, some things that seem so simple can do so much. Your computer screen may be a rectangle. The walls in your house meet to form right angles. Maybe. Even the molecules in your body combine to form certain shapes and geometric structures. As we'll learn in this course, the rules of geometry are really the laws of nature. So, before you begin the first unit of this course, make sure to locate the Careers in Geometry page on the PDF for this unit. Work through that activity before moving on. We are off to explore the mind of Euclid and see just where points, lines, and planes can take us. I'll see you in Unit 1.